hardware matures and evolves, and you know, you get to those later generations, I think you'll definitely start to see this be more functional, more gaming, it'll expand in different areas. Right now, most of the VR is focused on gaming. Gaming and entertainment.
Yeah, the Microsoft partnership. A lot of people are kind of wondering, will the revenue beyond the live streaming capabilities? Like, will you be
right now, it's just the live streaming capabilities. It's Xbox One streaming your headset. You're going to be able to do some new, really incredible things with that. Essentially see the people you're actually playing with in that game, multiplayer games, Halo, Call of Duty, Forza. So there's going to be a lot of cool VR bits that are enabled, some new magic that you get by playing inside the Rift. It's not just going to be a big screen, it's going to be a lot more. But that'll take time to evolve, and we're not making any announcements or any plans right now around actually plugging in.
So will that be like a customizable environment? Like a 4D theater experience?
Well, developers can do incredible stuff with this. I mean, developers get access to this SDK and this hardware, and they can go and they can decide what they want to send to your eyes. And if they want to have things coming out of the screen, if they want to put you in a sort of a plain-looking virtual theater, if they want to put a virtual theater that has a gross mood, or as a theme, like the game itself, they can do that. Tracking will allow for a bigger room area, so you will be able to move around, and we have a number of different things that we're going to be talking about as we move forward on this. And you should come to E3 and you should see the Oculus Touch experience.
How long will the board be?
I'm not sure that I actually don't know that off the top of my head, so I don't want to give you the wrong number. But a lot of those details will be releasing now as we get closer to the consumer base.